Hootie and the Blowfish, Dave Matthews, Kid Rock, and the Spin Doctors. They all have two things in common. They have all played in Winston-Salem, and they all know tonight's newsmaker.
He is an authority of booking big-name artists, and he's been doing this for more than 20 years. 2 weeks from today will mark what could be his career's biggest milestone. That's when Jay Stevens will reopen his legendary music hall with the familiar name.
I turned down probably 20 people that called me and said, hey, we want to put Ziggy's in this spot or that spot. And I was adamant not to go into a bar that had been a bar or a shopping center that was a strip mall. Yeah.
Here on North Trade Street, on the north side of downtown Winston-Salem's Arts District, sits a building that's about to become the city's newest concert venue.
In today's economy, metal buildings are the way to go.
But it's what will happen inside that'll make this place rock.
We fit 1,000 in this room alone.
It'll also continue Jay Stevens's passion for music, which he developed at a young age.
Oh, I had 2,000 albums when I was growing up.
Excuse me, 2,000 albums?
In seventh grade, I had 2,000 records.
And many of those records traveled with him to Winston-Salem in the mid-1980s when he attended Wake Forest University. But during his senior year, an automobile accident left him paralyzed and in a wheelchair.
And with the settlement from my accident through insurance, I was able to afford to buy Ziggy's, and that's how I started in 1990 with it.
I got a little bit of smoke and a whole lot of wine.
Ah, Ziggy's, the old music hall that once stood on Beatty Street and named after the bartender who worked there many years ago.
What was the first big booking that you had that you were really pleased about?
The Spin Doctors.
Spin Doctors.
They weren't big names back then. They were playing for the door. I mean, Hootie and the Blowfish was playing at Ziggy's before I bought it. So I was like, Hootie and the Blowfish, who are they? Oh, you want to get them? They're one of our biggest bands. At $5, they sell out.
Another artist Stevens booked was a very young Dave Matthews. But despite all the many artists who performed at the old Ziggy's, Stevens had to close the place when he says development pushed him out in 2007.
He said, watch. It literally pops wheelies and jumps curbs and things.
Now, have you ever flipped over backwards?
Oh, yeah.
Stevens would spend the next several years cruising the streets of Winston-Salem looking for a place to relocate. Then he found a piece of property, a couple of investors, and a developer willing to build and lease him this building, where the main feature is the music hall with its large stage and a big mahogany bar off to the side.
The old Ziggy's was 750 people. This place holds 1,000 in the music hall side, 220 in our tavern side. That's a sign of popping wheelies. Here's our VIP room over here to the left.
If they pay double the cost of a regular ticket, 20 people can get a view like this from one of two VIP balconies on the building's top floor.
Now, would they be able to sit down, stand up?
Oh, yeah, there'll be leather couches, a wet bar.
In between the two VIP balconies is the mezzanine, capable of holding 250 people.
And this will take us down the hall to the tavern.
The tavern will feature a full-service restaurant and bar that even non-ticket holders can enjoy.
You can bring your family down. It's open 11 a.m. to 2 a.m.
Okay.
Feel free to sit at tables, enjoy yourself. And then if you want to come see music, you can come to the music hall, and that's a totally separate entity.
But the major draw will be the music.
So we go from bluegrass to rock to hip-hop to jazz to, you know, reggae weekly. And we really live by that motto. And we don't cornhole ourselves into being a rock club or a country bar. You're going to get the greatest artists, the best customer service, and the best food that you can find in the Triad.
In fact, Stevens already has many artists already booked, from Sean Colvin to Saving Abel. Now, on opening day, July 29th, in 2 weeks, there will be 10 local artists and or bands performing between 11 a.m. till 2 a.m. with just a $10 cover. Now, for more information on upcoming appearances at Ziggy's, ticket information, and even the tavern menu, check out the Ziggy's website at ziggyrock.net or take the link from this story on myfox8.com.
Welcome back.